if and when you find yourself in a moment where there's extra charge, or maybe there is an emotion or an internal experience that you're having that may feel difficult or uncomfortable.
Happy Monday, everyone. It's Sophie.
And Adi.
We're always looking for new ways to support you, and we know firsthand how life can get in the way.
So we've created 5-minute episodes with motivation from us and our great friends to keep you feeling ignited and inspired no matter what life throws at you.
Welcome to the Ignited Motivation Podcast. Mini episodes every Monday.
Listen while you brush your teeth.
Or on your morning walk.
And you'll never miss out on the latest tips and tricks that are keeping us feeling motivated.
Hello, everyone, and welcome. My name is Linnell Weiss from Whole Human Healing, and you are listening to Ignited Monday Motivation. So today I'm going to be talking to you guys about one of my favorite visualizations to use when dealing with a difficult emotion or difficult thought. So oftentimes when we experience negative thoughts or emotions that we deem unacceptable or negative or just challenging in some way, we're really given two options in terms of how we choose to respond. We can either respond with judgment and criticism and comparison and negativity, or we can choose to respond to ourselves with love and compassion and understanding and empathy. And although this seems like, you know, a pretty simple concept to hold on to as we move through life, in reality, when we're feeling charged and when we're feeling activated, it can feel pretty difficult to intentionally choose how we want to respond to ourselves in that moment. So here's a visualization that I really love to use to kind of help remind myself that I always have a choice and that, you know, I am always able to choose to respond to myself with kindness and with love. So I want you guys to either kind of imagine in your own minds or go back to a memory when you've been in a public place and you have witnessed a child having a tantrum. In that scenario, I want you to imagine two types of responding parents. You have the first parent who comes up to the child and essentially shames them for having their emotional experience. And so that could sound something like, and it doesn't mean it sounds exactly like this, but it could sound something like, "Why are you crying? Why are you screaming? We don't do this in public places. This is not okay. We have to go. We have to go. We're not going to do this here. You're not allowed to do this here." So even as I say that, I can feel a charge really kind of building up in my body, and I can feel that activation coming through. And I just want you to take a moment and check in with yourselves about what's going on internally as you take in that type of response. What's happening as you kind of hear that out? What typically happens to a child that is responded to with intensity, with negativity, with, you know, a lot of charge in a moment when that child is already feeling activated and already feeling pretty charged up, is that typically that child starts to act out their emotion even more. So again, I want you to imagine that you're in that supermarket, you just saw that parent respond to that child in a super, super charged way, right? And again, typically what we'll see is that child will start to either scream louder or kind of exaggerate, you know, their tantrum, or, you know, kind of like hitting the floor and just really exaggerating their movements and behaviors, because essentially what they're feeling and what they're experiencing hasn't been recognized and hasn't been validated. That's example number one. Now I want you to imagine that same child in that same supermarket having that exact same charged experience. Now, we think about parent number two. So that parent might see the child, feel all of that discomfort within themselves, and then choose to maybe get down on one knee and get sort of to the level with that child and look that child in the eyes and say, "Hey, you're really upset right now.
I understand that you're feeling really sad. Let's say in this example, the child really wanted a box of cereal that the child isn't allowed to get, right? So that parent, again, goes down on one knee, levels with the child, looks at the child and says, hey, I can see that you're really upset right now. I know that you really, really wanted that box of cereal and you're not able to get it. And that's really upsetting. And you know what? If I was in your shoes, I might feel really upset too. And I just want you to know that you're allowed to feel as upset and as angry as you want. And I will love you no matter what. So you can stay here for as long as you need. And I just want you to know that I'm here and I love you. And it's okay that you're having such big feelings about not getting the cereal. I would probably be upset too. So in this example, what that second parent is doing is turning towards the child, acknowledging the emotional experience that they are having, acknowledging that they understand why that child might be feeling the way that they do, and then soothing that child by letting the child know that no matter what happens, the parent will be there. The parent will love them. The parent will stay present for that child no matter what emotional experience they're having. And that is what teaches us whether feelings, specifically the more charged, difficult feelings, are okay and safe to feel or not. So my invitation to you guys this week is to consider how you are responding to yourself if and when you find yourself in a moment where there's extra charge, or maybe there is an emotion or an internal experience that you're having that may feel difficult or uncomfortable. And the invitation really goes back to which one of those adults are you really showing up as? Are you showing up as the adult who makes you wrong for the emotional experience that you are having? Or are you showing up as the adult who can level with the vulnerable, sensitive part of you and can align with that part of yourself enough to self-soothe? So thank you guys for tuning in. It is always such a pleasure to be with the Ignited family. And if you are interested in finding out a little bit more about me and my practice, or maybe curious about ways that we can work together, you can find my information on social media at Whole Human Healing, or you can find more information on my website, which is wholehumanhealingla.com. All right, guys, have a great week.
You just listened to the Ignited Motivation Podcast.
Did you love the mini dose of motivation? Please let us know. Your feedback and experience is our number one motivator. Leave us a review, subscribe, and share with your favorite people on your favorite apps. And don't forget to catch the next episode every Monday.
Because we want to hear from you. So join the conversation and discover bonus content on our website and Instagram. You can find the links in the show notes. Now that you're ignited, what are you motivated to take on?